blend it all together. Okay, so that's a really nice pale yellow. And you can get, there's a couple of companies that you can go online and get great makeup kits, like Joe Belasco is really good, Krylon is really good, and they have really good starter kits. Okay, so I've got all the lumps out of it. And you can see that's a few shades lighter than his skin, but it's in the same tonal family, which is really important.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'm going to get you to put it on his face all over. Okay? So even where he has hair, I'm going to get you to put it in there where he has hair. Okay? Because we really want to enhance every aspect of his face. Notice how I put a lot of makeup on with the brush?
Yeah.
We rarely use sponges. Sponges create, you can see where the sponge is being. So the brush is just easier to blend, okay? And once we've finished applying it with the brush, we'll go in just with the cotton pad. And again, we do that because when you're taking photos, high def photos, this gives you a finish that you can't read. So we're going to put that all the way, everywhere. Okay. Yep. Everywhere. Does anyone have any makeup questions?
Does that just wash right off the soap and water?
This does, yeah, and that's why I love working with it, because it doesn't matter how thick the makeup is. When we did actually Noche Latino for the Washington Ballet, they had 15 minutes to get out of the first look where they were completely white. They had white body paint, white hair, everything was white. So they had 15 minutes to get off stage, completely changed into their next look. That was a real challenge, to find the right product to be able to get removed really quickly, you know?
So in situations like that, do some of the dancers do their own makeup backstage, or are there artists that
want to? We have lots of hands, and again, it's a time thing, because they have some, I think they had 10 shows. So we went down with a team, and we helped them, but it was one of those things where they did each other, body-wise, and then we just sprayed their hair, and then we helped break them down. That's the term we use it. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I have a question. So once you get the idea of Soap for Dracula, when you were approached with that idea, how many tries did it take you until you figured out the Dracula look? Do you do it on the actual dancer a couple times? Or do you do it on sketches?
You know what, we don't. And what I find with the Washington Ballet, because I work closely with Monica, who's the head of wardrobe, she works with Septine and Arthur. They've already done a long journey even before it gets to me. And because now I think this is like the sixth year I've worked with them, and I know the dancers really well. So when I knew that it was Lewis who was Dracula, I knew he would come with so much, it really made my job easy. Do you know what I mean? And again, because I know their skin, I just know them, you know, I knew it was going to be an easy fit. Do you know what I mean? And the nice thing is, with that caliber of professional, they take on that personality, which is amazing. You know, it really is. It's really cool. Okay, so she's run out, and we don't really want to make it too heavy. So this is what I love about my magic drops. Okay, so we're going to put it on the brush, the magic drops, and we're going to put it on there, and we're going to spread that all the way through.
I'm going to pull another raffle, and this program is part of a partnership with the Washington Ballet, and the Washington Ballet donated tickets, and so what we're raffling off are tickets to the ballet to see Dracula at the Kennedy Center. And the winner is 8430, the last four digits.
Is that you?
Okay. Oh, lovely.
Oh,
is really making his hair really pop out.
Mm-hmm.
Even more. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So that's a big part of it too, is really knowing what you have to work with and what you have to work with making it really project out. Right. Enjoying this.
It's very relaxing.
Spa day.
Now, a big part of it is really mattifying his lip color. You know what I mean? We've got to really take that.
Can I put it on?
Uh-huh. And it tastes fine. It's pretty neutral tasting. Doesn't that make a big difference? You know what I mean? And that's a big part of it, is knowing what to leave and what to take away.
Do you ever watch any of all the YouTube videos about the makeup tutorials?
Oh my gosh, I love them. I'm addicted. I'm so addicted.
Yeah. It's really a different world for these days.
Oh my gosh, totally. So now I'm just going to, and I'm going to, so now what we're doing is we're just going to really blend in his hair so that it just, see how this eyebrow is really nice and neutral, so that's what we're going to do. And you can rub and rub and rub this, and it's not really going to go away until we use soap and water. Okay, so let's go over here and let's look and see how he's looking. It's a good base, isn't it? It's a good base.
Yes, yeah, she has a her hand, nice movement.
Oh my gosh, totally. Because what the eye can see and what you can see,
so is it more just like put someone heavier, or is it the colors are more exaggerated? How do you compensate for that?
That's a really good question, because it really depends on the lighting. If you have white lights, then it needs to be brighter and bigger. Whereas with the Washington Ballet, because the lights change all the time, so it's really about the effect.
So
does
the look itself will change as the lighting changes.
Totally, totally.
Oh, wow.
You've done a great job there. Then make sure they're a little round instead of straight. And you know what, even if he lifts his cheeks up, like really make go, okay, and then do it that way. Because then when his face relaxes, you need to sharpen it. Yeah, see, and that's the, she's done a few and the pencil's already gone blunt, okay? The other trick too is we sometimes will heat up the pencil. You know, if we want to do a really dramatic look, we could heat the pencil up, and that makes the actual content softer, which then it's dispersed heavier. So there's lots of little tricks that you can do.
Cool.
Okay, so now let's go up to his forehead. Okay. So can you lift your eyebrows up for us? Are you good? Okay. So now keep it up there and just draw. That's it. Keep it up for me. Because see what I've got him to do with his forehead? Okay, so. And now relax down. Okay, see how that created a nice shape for me? Okay, so go back up again. Cool. Draw around. Mm-hmm. So it's all about the illusion, isn't it? If you want to stand back just a little and have a look and see. Now, I've got a little bit of black shadow, and I mixed it in with white, okay, and I've got a slimmer brush, so do the same thing, just raise your eyebrows for me. So we're going to do a few of those, okay, just relax your brow. Now, see how we're getting the texture there now? Okay. So we're going to do a few through here too. And what we're going to do with that color is we're going to blend a few through this bottom lip.
I'm sure you haven't done this before.
She's good. Yeah, no, keep doing that sign. See the texture in the two different colors and it's different? It just helps tremendously, doesn't it?
Is it okay if I fall asleep?
You don't know what you're going to look like when you wake up.
Yeah. I don't know what I look like now.
You're looking pretty hairy. Cool. That's great. Okay. So just do a few like this. And it's really hard to tell that that's not real hair, is it? You know what I mean? Mm-hmm.
great.
Mm-hmm. And that's the biggest secret, is knowing when to stop.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
That's amazing.
Is that why?
Transformation.